fell asleep amid the flowers for a couple of hours on a beautiful day. Daydreamed, I dream of you amid the flowers for a couple of hours. Such a beautiful day.
For my work experience, I had the great and amazing opportunity to go to St. Petersburg and work in a Cambridge International School just down from Lacta Tower, which is Europe's tallest building. My experience working at the school, very interesting to say the least. The children were great and the teachers that were around me were well dedicated to their work. When I finally had the opportunity to sit down and talk with a few of them, this is what they had to say.
What's it like to study in St. Petersburg?
What I like to study.
What is it like?
Oh, what is it like? It's really different because I was in Germany like 2 years ago. So it's a bit different. The style of teaching is, I think it's more easier than in Germany. I was in two school systems, one German, and now it's the English system. It's really different because in Germany it was like much harder to study everything and we didn't have enough time to do everything, and now it's like really easy.
What's it like studying in St. Petersburg?
It's harder than, because it's a different program completely from when I was studying in China. But I'm getting used to it, so it's good.
And what's it like studying in St. Petersburg?
Well, it's cold and I get sick a lot, but mostly, I mean, it has its benefits and not benefits, I guess, but the climate is the most problem.
Pros and cons?
Yeah.
Do I just have to, I don't have a list or something.
It's okay, you've got off the top of your head.
Climate. The pro is that it's a big city and you have a lot of opportunities here. Another benefit that it's not the capital with tons of people, but it's close to the capital. There's tons of, I guess it's good because you have a lot of options to choose from. Bad because you have a lot of traffic jams. Good that we are close, like all of us want to live close to the school, which is very good. So that's a benefit, I guess.
While I was at work experience, I met numerous children that had come from different backgrounds, some from Germany, some had stayed in Russia all their life, some that had lived in Mexico for 5 years. But a young girl, Wendy, had lived in London for a few years, so she sort of understood the UK. And I asked her what was the difference she felt between Russia and the UK. For one, she said it was cold. But what really interested me was that she said that the people have the same sort of values. When my work experience week was over, me and my sister decided to explore around the city. I'd only been once before, and we'd only really walked around and not really seen the sights. So when we had the opportunity to walk on the sea, that was a very different experience. You could hear the ice underneath you crack. St. Petersburg's history is very different to our own in the sense that it's not just lived through two revolutions, but it's also lived through numerous wars too. In World War II, it was under siege by the Nazis, and a lot of people starved and suffered badly. When I went, it was 2 weeks after the celebration of the 75th anniversary of the liberation there. Even though I have been to the Hermitage and been inside, apparently it would take someone 2 whole years to see every single room if they went every single day. When we got inside the Church of Blood, I wasn't expecting to see this absolute marvel of a building. I knew that Orthodox churches were decorated slightly differently to Catholic ones. The Church of Spilt Blood was a very different church that I've ever been in before. I say that because I've spent most of my younger years travelling and going to Italy or France, and I've seen lots and lots of different Catholic churches, but I've never seen an Orthodox one before. The Church of Spilt Blood, I have to say, was my first ever example of what an Orthodox church was like. Lots of gold and lots of blue and little tiny tiles that were dotted all the way up the church. Now, we then went from the Church of Spilt Blood to St. Isaac's, which is the more famous one. What I found different between the Orthodox churches and the Catholic churches is that even though the Orthodox church, St. Isaac's, it looked more like a Catholic church than it did an original Orthodox one, it still kept its originality and its beauty, how similar it is to the Catholic style, but yet still keeps its Orthodox roots and the icons it has that are still tiled in the old-fashioned way of doing things. My experience in St. Petersburg and walking around it, I have to say, was a delightful experience. I'd been to many other different cities before, but not quite like St. Petersburg. Even though it's counted as a European city, it didn't feel like one. I've been to Florence and I've been to Paris and lots of other different European cities, and they feel and look European in the sense that they either have a sort of Renaissance look to them, or they have a very Catholic look to them. I suggest if you want to ever go to St. Petersburg, you go in the winter. I went during the summer, and I did think it was a very beautiful city, but the only proper way of experiencing it is when it's in the snow. A deal of matchless value. I was always quick to admit defeat. Empty statements of hope.